Bonjour tout le monde. J'espère que vous allez bien. Alors, on est déjà à combien? On est déjà jour 4. Alors, on va essayer de faire ce qu'on peut pour vous aider quoi. D'accord? Alors, I just set this to start today, so I hope that you can hear it now as we're going, okay? So, this is the plan for this evening. I'm going to take one of the opinion pieces from a past paper, and then I'm going to go through the opinion, show you kind of what way to deal with it. And then for junior cert students, we're going to continue our written section. The one we did last night was décris ta famille, which is describe your family. Alors ce soir, ce que nous allons faire, nous allons regarder comment écrire, décrire votre maison. So how to describe your house, okay? So if we start with the leaving cert, okay? Now, the first thing I want to do is I want to talk to you a little bit about opinion pieces. What type of writing is involved, okay? So for an opinion piece, it's obviously it's your opinion about something, but it's generally a more factual, journalistic piece of work. I remember at school, when I was at school, they used to call them des rédactions. So you were writing your, if you like, your opinion about something. It was about maybe crime, about drug abuse, addiction, maybe the homeless crisis. And there are so many different ones. It's very, very hard. A lot of students send me messages to say, could you tell us what's coming up in the Leaving Cert? Look, there is no teacher in this country that can correctly say for definite 100% what is going to come up. We just don't know, okay? What you can do, and what I always suggest students do, is to learn about 12 different themes, okay? I do this with my own students, and it works really, really well. So have your vocabulary on the likes of health, education, culture, just different things like that, social problems, social issues, moral issues, the environment is always a big one, different things that are happening. Now, obviously, a lot of you are talking about coronavirus and all the rest of it. To be very, very honest with you, we don't know where we're at as regards the country, the economy, the education system. We know nothing. We're all in the dark for the moment. So don't be caught up too much in what's going to come up. I think what you need to be doing, and it's really, really important, is to develop your style of writing. Okay? And that's what I'm here to help you develop your style of writing. Okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you. We're going to look at this one. Okay? And this was from question one in the 2018 paper. Okay? Now, the good news is that this is available for you free to download from Frenchnotes.ie in the free resource section of the Leaving Cert, okay? So you don't have to scramble putting notes together. This is absolutely 100% available to you to download, okay? All you have to do is go to Frenchnotes.ie and download it. But first and foremost, I'm going to bring you through the process of writing an opinion piece, okay? Now, for my students, I say, look, it's generally five. Just think of the number five when you're doing an opinion piece. So I say you have a good, strong introduction, a good conclusion, and you've got 3 points in the middle. So your first point, so we're going to go through this particular one, okay, just to show you kind of what way I was thinking when I was putting this together, okay? And the first thing that I would say to you is, as usual, you have got to read your question so carefully, okay? And the question is, selon le texte de la section En France rurale, la vie devient de plus en plus difficile. So according to the text in section one, in France, rural life is becoming more and more difficult. Now, that's what they said, but then they went on to say, il faut faire plus pour améliorer la vie en Irlande rurale. So we must do more to improve, améliorer, that lovely verb, la vie en Irlande rurale, life in rural Ireland. Okay, what do you think? And there's the way they wrote that. Sorry. Qu'en pensez-vous? What do you think about this or about it? Okay, so that's It's not, you don't have to talk about life in rural France because guess what? There's a very good chance that you don't know a whole pile about life in rural France, but you do have an idea of what life is like in, and what we can do to improve life in rural Ireland, okay? It doesn't matter if you're from the middle of Limerick City or Galway or Cork or Dublin, you would still have an idea of what life can or must be like for people living in the country, okay? So I said, first and foremost, right? I said, à l'écart de la bousculade et du remue ménage de ville et des embouteillages. So you're away from the le train-train de la ville, you know, the kind of busy of the town and les embouteillages, which would be the traffic jams. You're saying that people that live in the countryside are surrounded by the sounds of nature. However, it means that you don't have access to prestations les plus indispensables comme les hôpitaux, les systèmes de transport qui sont sûrs et fiables. So you're away from hospitals, you're away from good transport. So qu'est-ce qu'on peut faire pour améliorer le sort, SORT, that's kind of the fate of people that live in rural zones or rural areas. Okay, so that was the introduction I wrote. Now, look, just take a look at that. There's an awful lot there. I mean, even if you were to write just even two lines of an introduction, that's plenty. Absolutely plenty. Why do I write so much? I write so much because I want to demonstrate different things to you, different points of grammar. You don't have to do that. You can keep it a lot less than that, okay? So then I have to make a clear point because you remember I was an examiner for years. I don't do it anymore, but when I was an examiner, what I really loved was for a student to give me a clear, structured answer rather than a stream of consciousness to try and get as much French onto the page as you possibly can. That's sometimes counterproductive. I always advise my own students to make a plan before they even attempt an opinion piece, because if you've a plan, there's a good chance that you'll stick to it, okay? If you've no plan, you know, it could be a case of repeating yourself or using words that, you know, you're using the same kind of thing the whole way through, the same kind of vocabulary. If you can take 5 minutes even to plan it, and you've loads of time in the Leaving Cert, do only the specified three opinion pieces or the three written pieces. Don't do four. Do three, but do three well is my advice to you, okay? And okay, if you do four, the examiner will obviously correct the four of them and give you the best mark out of four. But you know what? You're better off. There is a set time. They've given you that time. Use that time wisely. I will do a separate live on timing for the exam, so don't worry about that. That's not where we're at the minute. Where we're at is how you're going to, sorry, approach this Leaving Cert opinion piece, okay? So my first point, I'm saying that I would say that those who live in the countryside sont souvent les oubliés de notre société, are often the forgotten of our society. Aujourd'hui, le fait d'avoir accès à l'Internet est devenu essentiel. So the fact that you can have access to the internet has become essential. It's an essential part of life where so much is being done online. And I'm saying that it's a little like the electrification in the 40s. Cependant is a lovely word. Cependant, pourtant is another way of saying it. It means however. Nous nous retrouvons à présent avec des vastes zones d'Irlande rurale dotées de connexions lentes et de qualité médiocre. So I'm saying that, however, we find ourselves with huge parts of Ireland with very slow connections or bad quality connections. And I'm saying, il faut améliorer cette situation. Now remember, I'm harking back to what they said. What can we do to improve? Améliorer again. So here I'm using that verb down here. We have to improve the situation. Because this is unacceptable in a world which is always moving and becoming more and more technological. So that was my first point. My first point was about that they need an internet connection, okay? That a lot of them have been lost in society because for whatever reason, they don't have proper internet, and internet has become like the electricity of the 40s. But then I gave a second point, and I always think that it's important to kind of show two sides of the argument, okay? But here, what I've said is I've spoken about the closure of post offices. I've spoken about the closure of the commissariat. Commissariat would be your police stations. And I've also said that les possibilités d'emploi sont souvent dans les zones urbaines. So it's often easier to find employment in the urban areas. Now, I'm just going to stop for a second to remind my junior certs who are following me. I know that some of you are watching and saying, I thought you were doing junior cert. I am. I'm just going to go through leaving cert and then I'm going to want junior cert. So don't worry, I haven't forgotten my mes candidats au brevet. Huh? So don't worry about that. I haven't forgotten you at all. And then I have said, though, that Europe a généralement contribué au projet de développement rural. So let's face it, the European Structural Fund, it has helped for a lot of projects. Now, remember, I'm 49 years of age. I'm writing this as a 49-year-old. So maybe I might have done a little bit more research into it, or maybe it's just because I've lived a hell of a lot longer. But, you know, you can make it simpler and just say, you know what, à la campagne, il n'y a pas de bus. There are no buses. Il n'y a pas de transport en commun pour les jeunes. Moi, je veux aller avec mes amis et il faut que je demande à ma mère de m'amener. So you have to kind of go, you know, I have to wait for, you know, for my mother to bring me. So, you know, things like that's a problem for a teenager. And I have to recognize that they would be major problems. But I just want to give you a kind of an overview, okay, of the kind of things you can say. Now, for my third point, now, this is important because I always say, make your third point your personal point. Because remember, spontaneity, authenticity, that's really important for the Leaving Cert. Examiners love to see what an 18-year-old realistically thinks about something, okay? So what I'm saying is, I live in a village which is 10 kilometers from a city. If I'm sick, the hospital is 5 kilometers from me. If I want to go to town, I take the bus, right? But I could not understand, I could not imagine, je ne pourrais pas imaginer comment cela peut être difficile si j'habitais à des kilomètres de nulle part. So if I left miles from nowhere. And then I'm kind of saying where I live as well, I'm lucky that I can go on to university, which is quite near. But if I live in a really rural area, I have to get my parents to send me to a university in the nearest city or town or whatever. And sometimes that's quite far away. And then it's all the price that comes with that, okay? But then I'm saying, la vie campagnarde n'est pas toujours rose. So it's not always the best, okay? But il faut qu'on fasse plus. Il faut qu'on fasse plus. That's a lovely use of your subjunctive. Il faut qu'on fasse plus is, again, another way of saying we to improve the situation, okay? Pour rendre la vie plus facile pour ceux qui habitent en milieu rural. So to make life easier for people that live in a rural milieu or area. Then I set for my conclusion. And, you know, it might be your conclusion. It might be at the end of your opinion piece. You have to tell the examiner. And look how a nice way of saying it. Instead of en conclusion or pour conclure, you could write something like, oh God, I'm left-handed, so it really makes everything so difficult. Toute réflexion faite. So, toute réflexion faite, je crois que l'amélioration, again, your improvement de la qualité de la vie rurale, doit être vraiment au cœur de toute stratégie de développement social. It should be at the heart of all social development. And I went on, oh yeah, of course, what I do a lot is I kind of use this, I love this expression, il incombe à, it is up to. And of course, I'm saying, il incombe à notre gouvernement, it's up to our government, to really listen, de vraiment écouter ceux qui habitent dans les zones rurales, right, that live in rural areas, et améliorer la vie rurale en Irlande. And you're then going in again with improving life in rural Ireland. So that is an example of an opinion piece. Now, what you'll find, I'm just going to show you really quickly, okay, there, when you download it, okay, you're going to have, it's actually 8 pages, right, as a lot of my opinion pieces are on French notes, okay. So I have it written in French. I then have it written in English. Now watch, and I love this, right? I love it. Okay, I did it, but I still actually really love it. I've gone through all the key grammatical expressions that I've used, and I've put them in English, and in parts where I need to, I've explained them, okay? So they're really, really, I love these, right? And also, if you want, for help to do your own one, there's a big thing of vocab for you to download and keep. And I hope, j'espère absolument, j'espère que ça vous a plu. Now, leaving certs, you can go and download that if you'd like to stay on. Actually, if you're an ordinary level candidate, definitely this might be useful to you because we're going to do, it's like the form, you know, the form filling in the leaving cert, but definitely, pour mes candidats au brevet, for my junior cert, this is very important, okay? So here we are. We're working from the sample paper as was, that was written and designed by State Examinations. So it's a great one. Obviously, they know what they're talking about. So last night, we looked at Section C, which was the written for 80 marks, right? And we're on question 16. Now, it's not that I've done 15 questions. It's just I kind of, if you like, stuck the pen and said, okay, where am I going to start? I'm going to do a little bit of written with you, okay? So last night, we looked at décrit ta famille, and I asked you to write a short thing about your family. Now, what I actually did was I went through it with you, and I kind of told you the verbs that you're to use and all the rest of it. Lads, to be honest with you, these live streams are great because they stay up. They're not like an Instagram where they disappear after 24 hours. They stay up. So you can just refer to that and take a look at it, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to look at it, right? Now, your junior cert, you should have your present tense done. You should have a little idea of how you'd speak in the past and the future. Okay, those three tenses really are the most important, okay? After that, your teacher would have done adjectives with you, a few pronouns with you, and bits and pieces, okay? Now, what we need to do is we need to take all of that and we're going to put it together and make a couple of sentences. Now, most students that I talk to, whether they're in junior cert or leaving cert, the one thing they say is, Liz, this is all lovely, or Miss, if they're in school, but we can't write. We just don't know how to write. It's not that you don't know how to write. You're afraid. You're afraid to write, okay? All of you can write beautifully in English, but you're afraid to write in French because you're afraid of making mistakes, okay? I would say, don't be afraid, just write. And it reminds me, and I'm sorry, just very, very quickly, it reminds me of, I learned when I lived in France, I learned how to drive in France, right? And my driving instructor was a fellow from Martinique called Felix, right? Lovely fellow. And he said to me, I said, I can't. Look, I'm left-handed and the signs are all different and I can't do it. And he just said, just drive. Because you being afraid is not going to stop the fact that you're going to have to drive. And he told me that driving would become a reflex. And of course, I thought he was nuts, but he wasn't. And that is exactly what has happened. So the more you write, the more you take yourself out of your comfort zone and just write, the easier it's going to get. So I need you to try that, okay? But in the meantime, I'm going to help you with the structure, okay? So we're going to talk about my house. So think about it. You need to know the French for the rooms of the house. You're going to need, obviously, things like garden, small, big, things like that, okay? So we're going to go through it. I'm going to read it out to you, okay? And then I think I'm going to type it up and I'm just going to stick it here under the live or over the live or whatever way it's going to work. So I might do that because it's only a couple of lines. Look, just to show you again, right? Seriously, it's really small, okay? I can nearly leave it up there and read it, actually. It might be easier. So the first thing I said is, ma maison se trouve à la campagne. So I won't actually leave it up because I'm maybe too close to the screen. My house is situated à la campagne. Now, I said à la campagne, but you could be en ville, en banlieue. So it could be in the suburbs, dans un lotissement, in a housing estate. J'habite dans une grande maison. I live in a big house. J'habite dans une petite maison. But j'habite, J-apostrophe, H-A-B-I-T-E, is I live. J'habite dans une grande, petite, moyenne, you know, une maison moyenne. That's fine as well. A kind of an average house. It doesn't matter, right? It really doesn't matter. Any examiner is not going to be judging what kind of house it is. They're going to be judging, how did you say it or write it? That's the important bit. Dans ma maison, in my house. Now, I've used ma, okay? And ma is a possessive adjective, right? Oh my gosh, I'll never get this twisting. But anyway, ma maison. And a possessive adjective, right, is like my, your, his, her, right? So if you look here, it's ma. Now, it's not because it's my and I'm a girl, right? It's because house is feminine, right? So if it was, let's say, John saying my house, it would still be ma maison, because maison is a thing that counts, okay? I was doing that with my first years in CBS Sexton Street, where I'm a French teacher, very, very good school in Limerick. And I was doing it with my first years, and I was kind of going, and they were kind of going, would you not say son maison because it's his house? I'm like, no, it's still sa for his, because house never changes. The house is feminine. So, you know, it takes a bit of getting used to, but really just keep going. And there's a very useful grid, actually. Remind me of it. I could maybe do something about that. A really useful grid of how you use it. Okay, so that's important. So, dans ma maison, in my house, il y a. Remember, we saw it last night with il y a quatre personnes dans ma famille. Here we're saying il y a, and what we're saying is une cuisine, a kitchen. Un salon, a sitting, un salon. Une salle à manger, which is literally a room to eat. Un salle à manger, right, which is your dining room. Une salle de bain, a bathroom. Une salle de bain, a room of bath, of bathing, okay? Et trois chambres. Now, be very careful here, right? When we're saying chambre, I just want to show you something. You see chambre, I'm so bad at this, but I'll get there. Right, you see the word chambre? Okay, I should become the opposite, right? Chambre has an ORE at the end of it. You see the ORES there, trois chambres, S because there's three of them. Don't say chambre. No. Say chambre, chambre, as if the ORE didn't exist. That's the joy of the French language. Nous avons, your verb avoir, nous avons un jardin, devant et derrière la maison. Now, I have finished it with quite a difficult one, okay? And maybe it might be too difficult, but I'm going to show it to you anyway. J'adore où j'habite. I love where I live. Now, just one last thing, all right? Do you see that OU? Do you remember I had the accent there, okay? I have this really cringy way of remembering it that I'm going to share with you now. Oh, what am I doing? This is so bad. Okay, do you see that OU? Do you know that there are some words that are, there's another word, OU, that doesn't have the accent, okay? So one means or, that's without the accent. And this one means where. And how you remember it is you say, where is the accent? I know, it's cringy, but it works. And people remember. So that's kind of where we're at. And I'm going to continue doing these. I would absolutely, at this stage, I would absolutely love to thank all of you that sent me such really lovely messages. I hope that it's been useful for you. Please contact me, send me comments, let me know how you found it, and give me suggestions of what you'd like me to do on these live streams. As I say, I'm going to be here every evening, 8 o'clock, and hopefully I will be able to help as many of you as possible. Please share my Facebook with others, and do visit FrenchNotes.ie. you can download, as I said, this opinion piece is definitely in the free resource section of the Leaving Cert. Get on and download it, and just even look at the way it's put together, it'll help you. And for the junior cycle, I will definitely type this up and share with you. Okay, so voilà, je vous dis bonne nuit et j'y serai encore demain soir. So I will be back tomorrow evening. Okay, I learned how to turn this off, it's great. Bonne nuit! Yeah.